Muhammad could not have known these facts about human development in the 7th century because most of them were not discovered until the 20th century. This is a leech, and this is the human embryo, but 23 days. I think you have to agree that the similarity between these structures is amazing. Little was known about the staging and classification of human embryos until the 20th century. For this reason, the descriptions of the human embryo in the Quran cannot be based on scientific knowledge in the 7th century. The only reasonable conclusion is that these descriptions were revealed to Muhammad from God. He could not have known such details because he was an illiterate man with absolutely no scientific training. It is not surprising, then, that we relook to our holy scriptures for help and enlightenment. From what stuff hath he created him? From a sperm drop. He hath created him and then moldeth him in due proportions. Surah 80, Ayah 18 and 19. Thank you very much.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. I want to just briefly tell you, I'm sometimes asked, how come you're a Muslim? And I tell them, well, God showed me that I'm a Muslim. For the first 35 years of my life, I was a disbeliever. I knew there is no God, I didn't see any need for God, and I didn't believe in God.
السلام عليكم. بدأ بتحية الإسلام وبدأ يسرد قصته في اعتناق الإسلام. لقد مر عليه 35 عاما من حياته لم يكن مسلما ولم يكن مؤمنا بالمرة.
But ever since I was small I was interested in science, and as my knowledge of science grew 25 years ago in basically a flash, I came to the conclusion that the universe is so perfectly made and everything so perfectly matches together that there must be God. So in one second I went from certainty there is no God to certainty there must be God and only one God.
يقول أنه كان مهتما دائما بالعلم وكان يرى إحسان الصنع في هذا العالم وكيف يسير وكان يقول لنفسه لابد أن هناك إلها يحكم تسير هذا العالم من اهتمامه بالعلم.
So I accepted there is God. I said أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.
وبذلك أدرك أن هناك إلها وشهد الشهادة.
But I was not looking for a religion. I thought all religions are wrong. Christians say this is one. The Jews said, Jews are chosen people, and if you're not Jew, you're not chosen. And about Islam, I only had negative information.
هو آمن بالله ولكنه كان يرى أن ليس هناك من دين صحيح حتى ذلك الوقت. فالمسيحية تقول هؤلاء الثلاثة واحد. واليهود يقولون هم شعب الله المختار. ولكنه أدرك أن هناك إلها ولكنه لم يكن يعرف شيئا عن الإسلام حتى ذلك الوقت.
But I didn't want to stay ignorant about religions, so I said, okay, I read Bible, and I saw in the Bible there are places which you know come from God, you feel it in your heart, but you see there are places which come from man, because this page says something that is opposite to the thing that was said a few pages ago. So I knew that Bible was written by man many years after the prophets.
قرر أن يتعلم عن الأديان وبدأ بقراءة الإنجيل ولكنه وجد في الإنجيل شيئا يلامس قلبه فأدرك أن هذا من عند الله من كلام الله الصحيح وصفحة أخرى من الإنجيل تناقض ما قالته الصفحة الأولى فأدرك أن هناك الكثير من الكتابات كتبت بعد سنوات وأعوام طوال من الرسل.
And I bought a Quran, English translation of the Quran. And when I started reading it, I started reading it with the same idea that just like Bible, it was written by man. Only in this case, we know the name of the man, Muhammad.
ولكن بدأ يقرأ القرآن وكان ظنًا أنه يقرأ كما قرأ الإنجيل أو الأناجيل من قبل ظنًا منه أنه سيجد به بعض الأجزاء من عند الله وبعضها الآخر كتبها إنسان ما عرف اسمه محمد.
And then when I was maybe about one third in Quran, I remember telling my wife, you know, this Muhammad, he must have been a very smart, very intelligent man because this book is very clear, very logical, very easy to follow, and there are no contradictions.
في ذات المرات كان يقرأ وقال لزوجته لابد أن محمدا كان ذكيا للغاية فهذا الكتاب الذي جاء به سهل تماما ومنطقي في تسلسله وترتيبه ولا يجد الإنسان أي صعوبة في التعامل معه.
But then as I read later, I suddenly saw a scientific fact which I knew was only discovered in the 20th century.
ولكنه أثناء قراءته لفت نظره آية تتكلم عن حاجة علمية شيء علمي عفوا لم يكتشف إلا في هذا القرن العشرين.
So immediately I saw that Muhammad is not the author of the Quran. That Muhammad is a messenger sent by God to give the Quran to mankind.
وهنا أدرك أن محمدا ليس هو كاتب هذا النص ولكنه رسول أرسله له بهذا الكتاب للناس.
So I saw, mashallah, Muhammad Rasulullah.
قال أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله أنا محمد رسول الله.
So I said, mashallah, I'm a Muslim.
ثم قال ما شاء الله أنا مسلم أصبح مسلما بتلاوته للشهادة.
And people asked me, well, how did you react? You said you heard bad things about Muslims. You didn't know anything about Islam. How did you react? Did you want to be Muslim?
هناك من سأل كيف أسلمت؟ إنك تعرف أشياء سيئة عن المسلمين ولم تكن تعرف كثيرا عن دينهم فكيف أسلمت؟ ماذا حدث؟
So, mashallah, when that was the greatest blessing on my wife, of my life. I have wonderful family, I have wonderful children, wife, everything. But the greatest blessing was that God showed me His guidance. And when I pray, I make dua, God please Let me die as a believer. Let me never disbelieve again.
لم يكن له خيار إلا أن يكون مسلما. فكما قال أنه ولد طفلا ونما وكبر وأدرك أنه ولد ولم يكن له في ذلك خيار. ولكنه وجد أن لا خيار له سوى الإسلام وبذلك أصبح مسلما وهو دائما يصلي ويدعو يدعو الله ألا يتركه يموت على ملة غير الإسلام بعد أن اهتدى إليها.
In closing, I would like to thank the organizers for making this conference possible.
في الختام أريد أن أشكر القائمين على تنظيم هذا المؤتمر لأن خرج على هذا المستوى على هذا
النحو. I think conferences like this are extremely useful.
وهذه المؤتمرات أعتقد أنها مفيدة ومجدية للغاية.
But I would like to appeal to the organizers that they do not make these conferences only in the Middle East. I think conferences like this should be made in London, in Frankfurt, in Paris. I would like to thank you for your attention. Shukran jazilan and salamun alaikum.